a key feature of public health is epidemiology, which in basic terms is the science of how exposures affect the overall health of society. A major avenue that epidemiologists use to link exposures to outcomes or diseases is with biostatistics, which at its most basic level is the use of data and probabilities to measure the effect of one health-related factor on another. For example, the effect of cigarettes on the likelihood of developing lung cancer. In real-world research, the exposure-outcome relationship is commonly unclear due to various biases or errors, but epidemiologists use statistical tools to improve the clarity of these relationships. Finally, it is important to remember that epidemiology is interested in the study of the collective health of many people, not individual cases of exposure and outcome. For a more formal definition of epidemiology, it is the study of the distribution and determinants of diseases and injuries in human populations. Epidemiology has many purposes, including studying the course or natural history of disease, determining the frequency of disease in populations, identifying the pattern of disease occurrence, identifying risk factors for and potential causes of disease, and evaluating the effectiveness of preventative and treatment measures. The ultimate goal of epidemiology is to apply this knowledge to the control of disease through prevention and treatment. Epidemiology, like other scientific subjects, has basic building blocks that make it unique. Epidemiology at its core is the study and analysis of persons, places, and timing of health-related exposures and outcomes in populations. Beyond persons, places, and timing, epidemiology is also a comparative science, focusing on comparison between groups and populations with the goal of making inferences about how exposures and outcomes may vary by group. The comparative goals and fusing of biological inference and statistical methods make epidemiology a unique and key discipline in the field of public health. To show how the basic building blocks of epidemiology relate to a real example, consider the 2001 anthrax bioterrorism attacks. Anthrax is a deadly bacterial infection that can infect the skin, lungs, gastrointestinal tract, and bloodstream. It is spread via bacterial spores from the bacterium Bacillus anthracis, which can survive for long periods of time in the environment. As part of the attack, five letters containing anthrax spores were mailed on September 18, 2001 to ABC News, CBS News, NBC News, The New York Post, and The National Enquirer. Two more letters laced with anthrax were mailed to U.S. senators on October 9, 2001. The attacks resulted in five deaths and 17 infections. Next, let's get into the actual epidemiology. Remember, we use three key terms in epidemiology: persons, places, and timing. Let's apply these to the anthrax example using the CDC report. First, persons. There were 22 cases of bioterrorism-related anthrax, with 11 confirmed as inhalational anthrax and 11 as cutaneous anthrax. 12 individuals were mail handlers, 6 were media employees, and 4 were placed in the other category, where investigators were unsure how they were exposed. Next, places. Letters containing spores were sent to media mail offices and U.S. senator offices. Letters were sent through mail sorting and delivery centers before arriving at final destinations. Cases were confirmed in 7 U.S. states. Finally, timing. The first cluster of cases occurred 4 days after letters were mailed on September 18, 2001. Onset of symptoms for this cluster occurred on September 22, 2001 to November 14, 2001. The second cluster of cases occurred 5 days after the letters were mailed on October 9, 2001. Onset of symptoms for the second cluster occurred from October 14 to October 22. The CDC estimated that 32,000 people initiated antimicrobial prophylaxis in order to prevent infection. Now let's apply epidemiological comparison to the anthrax example. Cases from the October 9th U.S. Senator envelopes were 31 times as likely to be inhalational disease than cases from the September 18th envelopes, suggesting that the October 9th mailing was associated with more severe illness. Comparing the September 18th envelopes to the October 9th envelopes, cases from the September envelopes were more likely than the cases from the October envelopes to be exposed to anthrax at news media facilities than at postal facilities. However, the CDC could not determine numerically how much more likely exposure was at the news facilities. Although this is a brief explanation of the 2001 anthrax attacks, use it to remember the basic building blocks of epidemiology. To further expand the explanation of epidemiology as a comparative science, it is important to understand what population differences are commonly studied. Factors frequently compared in epidemiology include geographical differences, or where populations live and work, demographic differences, such as race and sex, genetic differences, personal exposures, such as smoking or obesity, biological differences, such as hormone imbalances or variations in blood type, social and economic factors, such as socioeconomic status or education level, along with many others. Examples of comparative epidemiology research questions include: does one geographical area have a higher frequency of disease than another? And do the characteristics of a person with the disease distinguish them from those without it? A common misunderstanding is the difference between the roles of epidemiologists and physicians. Although both epidemiologists and physicians are interested in determining causes of disease and prevention of disease, there are stark differences. Physicians are interested in disease and outcomes at the individual level, with the primary role as a provider of treatment, while epidemiologists are interested in a much broader study of population disease in the interest of trends, comparison, and prevention. So, to bring all of this together, what is epidemiology as a scientific discipline most interested in? First, epidemiology has an aim to describe the health of populations through determining the overall level of disease, the frequency of disease in specific groups, and trends in disease occurrence. Secondly, epidemiology has a goal of explaining etiology or discovering the causal factors in the occurrence of disease and modes of transmission. Epidemiology is also interested in disease prediction or forecasting of the frequency of disease in populations. Finally, epidemiology aims to control the distribution of disease by preventing new cases, eradicating existing cases, and prolonging the life of those with disease.